Morning, St. John Lutheran Church. Welcome to worship. It's a joy to gather with you on this blessed Sunday morning. As we gather, I want to say a word of welcome also to everybody who's participating in worship by way of the live stream or watching the recording at a later time. Welcome. For those of you who are participating in the live stream, you are invited and encouraged to join with the congregation as we receive the Lord's Supper. If you're watching the recording at a later time, I would ask that you hold off on receiving the sacrament. If you would like to receive it, I invite you to either attend worship in person, tune into the live stream, or let me know and I'll be happy to bring it to you. As we gather today, we are going to have an opportunity in our time of assembly this morning to lift up our prayers. I'm going to ask for prayer requests in just a second, but I've already got a couple. So I'm going to write these down. I think that's all of the ones that I already knew about. Okay. Any prayer requests this morning? Yes, Carol. Lord, have mercy. Blessings to you and your family, Carol. Yeah, Sandy.
For my friend Lois, we prayed for her a few weeks ago with the devastating medical news. She had a stroke this past week.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
And also for our friend Chuck, who fell and broke his leg in places.
Oh, my goodness. Thank you, Sandy. Yes, Liz.
For my mother, who's starting some bladder cancer treatment.
And her name, Liz?
Jane.
Jane. Wonderful. Any others? Yes, Jessica.
I'm not sure about Gil, but you're passing.
Yes. Who is it? Jim? Okay. Ah, okay. Got it. Okay. Any other yes, Brianna. Oh, yes. Thank you, Brianna. Any others? Yes, Carol.
I'm sure it's on there, but the conflict in the Middle East.
Got that one down. Yes, thank you, Carol. Any other prayer requests? All right. With that, let's take a moment to prepare our hearts for worship. Oh, actually, hold one. Need to let the people on the live stream know how they can submit a prayer request. If you are tuned into the live stream and you have a prayer request, you can text that to me. The number is 920-288-2219. Please get your prayer request to me by the hymn of the day. If it's after that, we may not be able to get it in our assembly this morning, but I will hold your prayers in my personal prayer life. Thank you. And with that, we'll take a moment to prepare our hearts for worship. Please rise as you're able. Our worship continues with our thanksgiving for baptism. Alleluia! Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed.
Alleluia. Refreshed by the resurrection life we share in Christ, let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We thank you, risen Christ, for these waters where you make us new, leading us from death to life, from tears to joy. We bless you, risen Christ, that your Spirit comes to us in the grace-filled waters of rebirth, like rains to our thirsting earth, like streams that revive our souls, like cups of cool water shared with strangers. Breathe your peace on your church when we hide in fear. Clothe us with your mercy and forgiveness. Send us companions on our journey as we share your life. Make us one risen Christ. Cleanse our hearts. Shower us with life. To you be given all praise with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God now and forever. Amen. We join in our gathering hymn, Alleluia, Jesus is risen. Seated, I'd like to have the children of the congregation come on up for just a minute. Good morning, everybody. It's great to see you all. Come on up, come on up, come on up. How's it going, everybody? Good? You're doing good? Anybody less than good? No? You're great. Great. Oh, awesome. What's that? You lost a tooth? Did you find it? Sorry, I didn't do that before I was a dad. That's how it goes. But Tooth Fairy come and make it right? Awesome, awesome. Dig it. Nice. Wonderful. Good morning. So I'm glad you all are doing well, but you know what? I'm bummed. Oh, man. So I got this friend out in Oregon. His name is John Stevens. He is the pastor of Zion Lutheran Church in Oregon City, Oregon. And he helps me and a lot of other pastors week in and week out with what we might be able to say when we spend time with you guys, right, in our children's sermon. And this week, he had a cool one. Oh, it was so awesome. He talked about maybe using some invisible ink and sharing a message about how God changes us. And so, like, we can't see something, but then we do. And it was so cool. And so I thought, man, I'm going to do that. And to make sure that it actually worked right, which is not really my style, I went ahead and ran a test yesterday. And it didn't work. And I was bummed. Have you ever had that happen to you? That you thought you were going to be able to do something, and you had such high hopes, and it just didn't work out, and you couldn't do that thing? Man, that stinks, doesn't it? I really wanted to show you this, and I even had this way that I was going to connect it to our baptismal candle out there, which if somebody out in our lobby could light that, it would be awesome because it's Easter. Dylan, you can do that. Go, there's a lighter over there. Jessica can tell you where it is, okay? But we were gonna use that candle to make the invisible ink come alive, right? Because then we get a connection about how our baptism changes us. It was going to be so awesome. And I can't do it. Sorry. But here's the thing. Even when some of our hopes and our plans don't work out the way that we want, or we can't do one thing, we can still do other things. God gives each of us a variety of gifts so that we can bless our neighbors and take care of the world around us. And if one thing doesn't work, that doesn't mean that we call it quits, all right? So even though I could not do this really cool invisible ink thing, and you know what? I'm going to work on it, all right? Because I'm hopeful that someday we're going to get to do this, and I'll get to surprise you some other time with it, right? But even when we can't do stuff like that, we can do something else. And so what I want you to know today is that God loves you so much that God hasn't just given you one way to take care of the world around us. God has filled your life with all kinds of amazing gifts. And if we stop and think about the ways that we can be a blessing, we can see that even when some ways aren't for us, maybe that's for somebody else, there's always going to be some way that we can take care of our neighbors and show them that God loves them too, okay? I hope you remember that when things are going rough and it's not exactly the way you plan, all right? That there is still a promise of Jesus' love for each and every one of us, okay? Will you say a word of prayer with me? Thank you, Dylan. Okay, nope, sorry. We're going to include Dylan in the prayer. How's that? Dear Jesus, thank you for Dill. Thank you for your whole church. For giving us all so many different gifts to share your good news, to be a blessing to one another and to all creation. Help us to trust you and to trust your promise that you're working through each of us. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, thanks for coming up. You guys have fun in Sunday school, okay? Please rise as you're able. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. Have mercy, Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. For the reign of God and for peace throughout the world, for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. Have mercy, Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy for your people here who have come to give you praise for the strength to live your word. Let us pray to the Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Help, save, and defend us, O God. Amen. Now the feast of let us pray. Holy Lord, your followers gave to your children something more powerful and more valuable than riches. They gave healing and hope. Bring healing and hope into our world and show us evidence of your presence in our lives. Amen. Please join me as we read our psalm responsively. Praise the Lord. Praise, O servants of the Lord, praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, from this time on and forevermore. From the rising of the sun to its setting, the name of the Lord is to be praised. The Lord is high above all nations, and his glory above the heavens. Who is like the Lord our God? Who is seated on high? Who looks far down on the heavens and the earth? He raises the poor from the dust and lifts the needy from the ash heap, to make them sit with princes, with the princes of his people. He gives the barren woman a home, making her the joyous mother of children. Praise the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia. A reading from Acts. Glory to you, O God. One day, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the hour of prayer, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And a man lame from birth was being carried in. People would lay him daily at the gate of the temple called the Beautiful Gate so that he could ask for alms from those entering the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked them for alms. Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." And he fixed his attention on them, expecting to receive something from them. But Peter said, "I have no silver or gold. But what I have, I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, stand up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and raised him up. And immediately And immediately his feet and ankles were made strong. Jumping up, he stood and began to walk, and he entered the temple. He entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. All the people saw him walking and praising God, and they recognized him as the one who used to sit and ask for alms at the beautiful gate of the temple, and they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. Grace, mercy, and peace to you this morning from our triune God. Amen. You know, the first people who read Acts, they probably read it after they read Luke. And in Luke is nicer to Peter than Mark is. But Peter still doesn't come off looking all that great in the story of Jesus' life that Luke tells. Peter messes stuff up all the time. And then we get to this next book, Acts, that Luke wrote. And Peter is able to do what Jesus did. He's able to give a person who can't even stand up. He gives him healing that allows him not only to just stand up, but the next thing you know, he's leaping around. And I can only imagine, for people who don't know the full story of the life, death, and resurrection and the early church and all of that, as well as some of us might, if you were new to the whole thing, you might be a little bit confused and you go like, hold on, is there like a different Peter here or something? Because this Peter is not the guy that was around during the life of Jesus. Something has changed in him. He's a different dude. When I think about that, I think about, me. Not that I've ever been able to tell a guy to stand up and he just starts jumping around and everything like that. I've never performed miracles like that. But I think about where I am in my life today and where I have been. I think about my manager at Papa John's when I was in college, who I asked for a recommendation to seminary. And he said, you know, Josh, you're a nice enough guy, all right, but you are not what I envision when I think of a pastor, and I really just don't feel comfortable doing that. Okay. I think about Miss Vedetto. I think about Miss Vedetto, who was my Sunday school teacher in like third or fourth grade. I think about her and that night when I was in high school and she was giving me a ride to youth group, and she said, you know, Josh, when you were in third grade, I hated you. It was such a joy to invite her to my ordination. I think about all of that, and I think, too, as I've been thinking about this reading and how much Peter has changed and who he was and who he is in this story. And I think about, I don't even remember what year it was. It was, I was in upper elementary school. In the summer of 1985, my congregation called a new pastor, and I wasn't really sure about him because I really liked the last guy, and I didn't want this new fella taking my last pastor's place in my heart, and it didn't take me long to figure out, okay, this new fella, he's okay too, and he probably is as much of an influence on me becoming a pastor as anybody else. I'm not going to tell you where he lives now because he doesn't need any hate mail, okay? But but Pastor Paul was just so amazing. And even at a very young age, when I was in elementary school, he started entrusting me and other kids in our church with leadership roles to share our gifts with the wider congregation. And now looking back, I see that he had it in for me to become a pastor. Maybe he didn't know that, but he kind of set me on this trail a long time ago. About a year or two after he got to that church, there was a family in my congregation that was very dear to the congregation. They might have even been charter members. It was a fairly young Mission Start congregation, but they were very dear to my family. And Jim died of cancer when I was in elementary school in the summer. And Pastor Paul was talking to me after church on a Sunday, and he said, "You know, we're having a funeral for Jim this week, and I would like you to come and be an acolyte at that funeral." There was no way on earth that I was going to say no to Pastor Paul. There's no way. I was absolutely terrified. I was really freaking out about this. But I was doing a fairly good job of hiding it, at least until bedtime the night before the funeral. And I lost it. I lost it completely. And I'm being comforted by my parents. And my parents said, "You know, this is going to be tough for you. But Marlene, Jim's wife, and their kids, Michelle and Mike, who were also very dear to me, they were the older kids that I totally looked up to. Michelle had been my Sunday school teacher when I was like in preschool. I loved this family. And my parents said, "You know what? You can be a blessing to them tomorrow." I'm, oh, man, I just didn't think I could do it. To this day, I remember sitting up there on this side of the chancel, and the family is right there, and I remember the grief. I remember the grief in Michelle's face as she was there with that congregation and friends who loved her, hearing a word of new life for her dad and for her. To this day, thinking about Michelle sitting on that front row, because that's not where they sat. They sat back like where Mary is. To think of them sitting there that day, it still moves me. And you know what? Pastor Paul said, "Hey, you did a good job. I'm going to need acolyte for more funerals." Oh, man. Oh, man. I'm going to have to do this again? Interestingly enough, like 40 years later, funeral ministry, if you were to ask me, is one of the things that I'm actually pretty good at as a pastor. There's plenty of things that I fall short in. I'm still trying to learn those and still trying to grow. But isn't it interesting that calling so long ago started to change something in me? And that really, really is one of the things that I just think that I tend to do well. And if I've fallen short with you and your family, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. But I hope that you will pray for me. I hope that you will give me forgiveness and grace and encourage me so that I can do better for the next people who are experiencing loss in our congregation. I tell all of you that not to brag or anything, but just to recognize that I've seen in my life a change and an ability to use the gifts that God has put into my hands to grow as a Christian, to grow as a fellow member of the body of Christ. And you know what? If Peter can change and grow and use his gifts in the body of Christ, and a guy like me, whose manager at Papa John's wouldn't even write him a recommendation to go to seminary, can do it, there might be hope for you yet, huh? Maybe God is changing you in your life to be a blessing too. And with that, I'd like the ushers to hand something out. Oh, see, it's all a setup, huh? So this is our Saints in Service sign-up sheet, okay? Our council has been talking about this for a while. If you are a visitor and you're thinking that St. John might be a place for you, feel free to take one. It's not. But if you're a visitor and you're not so sure, don't worry about it, okay? Everybody else, I am totally talking to you, all right? For quite a while, our leadership of our church has been talking about how to get individual members of the congregation more involved in our time together on Sunday mornings. This has nothing to do with committee structure or other stuff. This is our worship life together. That is all, okay? Pre-COVID, we did a really, really good job of generally having people on a Sunday morning ready to go with certain responsibilities. When we kind of eased back into gatherings together, that wasn't so much a priority. We had a lot of other things that we were trying to figure out. Well, COVID, like the pandemic, is over and done with, and it is time for us to essentially relearn the patterns that we were fairly good at before and see how we can change them. So, with that, I want you to know that there is a place for service for you in our gatherings on Sunday morning. Whether it's out there greeting people as they come in, serving as an usher, and if you don't come with other members of your household, that's okay. You can still usher. It doesn't have to be just a family thing. We can hook you up with other people. We have need of people to help serve communion. I would love to have an assisting minister again. All right? There are so many ways that you can serve. And I trust that God has given you gifts to do just that. And we would like you to fill this out today. Okay? If you don't fill it out today, no worries, because it's going to show up in your email as well. All right? And if we don't get one from you soon, we will remind you, okay? We're going to do that because God is changing you. I truly believe that the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ means something in each and every one of our lives. Each and every one of us can be used to share the gifts of God's grace, God's love, and God's life with our community and with the rest of the world. And doing that in this space is, in a way, practice so that we can know how to share God's gifts of grace out in the world with strangers, with people who need to be raised up to that new life just as we have. So, I hope that you will give some serious thought to how you might be a blessing to this congregation, and in doing so, learn how your life is being changed to share the good news of Jesus Christ even outside of these doors. Thanks be to God. With that, let's stand up. You can fill out the rest of it later, turn it in, or actually, you know what? Even if you want to fill them out today, you can leave them kind of by the attendance pads in each row, all right? We will collect them there, or you can put it in my mailbox out there, anywhere except for the recycling bin, okay? We'll find them. But for now, we're going to stand up and sing our hymn of the day. Together with the whole church, we confess our faith. We use the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come into glory to judge the living and the dead. And his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, we pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news. God, our Holy One, you feed our deepest hungers. As we share the holy meal that is the body and blood of Jesus given for us, lead us to share all that we have and to find in generosity abundant life. God of grace, God our Creator, you bring forth all life on earth. Calm storms, bring water to parched places, protect the climate that this planet would sustain life in all its variety. God of grace, God our Savior, you offer wisdom and guidance beyond all human knowledge. Instruct lawmakers, judges, and elected officials to make decisions grounded in your justice and your hope and care for all people. God of grace, God our Elder, you care for all your children. Encourage those who are in times of transition, facing the loss of old ways and routines and anticipating change. Guide those who journey in grief, hope, and uncertainty. We pray for those in need of your gracious healing. We lift up Sandy, Catherine, John, Jasmine, Lois, Isla, Dan, Heidi, Dale, Judine, Mary, Terry, Nancy, Chuck, and Jeanette. God of grace, God our Creator, you bring all people together in you. Help us to remember our identity and purpose in our ministry. Help us to discern how we can be instruments of your grace to one another. Move us to love our neighbors as ourselves and to share in beloved community. God of grace, God our hope, God our help, God our strength, we lift up to you our loved ones in need of your healing. We pray for Karen, Lannis, NJ, Daryl, Janet, Lloyd, Lois, and Chuck. Draw near and hold them in your loving and healing embrace, raising them to new life. We pray too for the nations of this world. We pray for our siblings in Sydney, Australia, that they would know your presence in the midst of suffering and struggle after the recent stabbings. We pray for the nations of the world that are in conflict. We pray for the people of the Ukraine. We pray too for the tension, the conflict, and the war in the Middle East. For the people of Israel, Palestine, Iran. Break our hearts of stone, Lord, and give us new hearts of love and peace. God of grace, hear our prayer. O God, our resting place, your Son Jesus promised that we are held in your love forever. We remember our beloved who have died. We remember Annabelle, Bill, Alan, Jim, and Dale. As we remember them, we pray for Teresa and Paul and Noah and their family and friends. We hold in prayer Tony and her family and friends. We hold in prayer Carol, her family and friends, the friends and family of Jim, the Fettermans, and all who miss Dale. As we remember and share their love, comfort those who mourn. God of grace, into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's share a sign of that peace with one another. Our worship continues with the offering. Please rise. Let us pray. Risen One, you call us to believe and to bear fruit. May the gifts that we offer here be signs of your abiding love. Form us to be your witnesses in the world through Jesus Christ, our true vine. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is in our duty and delight that we should everywhere and always offer thanks and praise to you, O God, through Jesus Christ, who by his death on the cross and glorious resurrection broke the bonds of sin and death and gave life to all creation. And so with the church on earth, all creation and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy are you, God of power and might. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in your name. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, he gave thanks, and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us be bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. As we gather around Christ's table, a brief word of instruction for those who are participating in worship by way of the live stream. As we share the gifts of bread and wine, I invite you to share these words with one another. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. If you're worshiping by yourself, know that you gather with the whole body of Christ and hear these words of promise. This is the body of Christ given for you. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. If you don't receive the sacrament, know that the promises are for you as well, that Jesus has given his life for you and he loves you very much. For those of us who are gathered in this space, we will receive the Lord's Supper by table. I invite you to come forward at the direction of the ushers. All is ready, all are welcome, and all means all. Thank you. the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Ken, we go out here. Let's pray. Shepherding God, you have prepared a table before us and nourished us with your love. Send us forth from this banquet to proclaim your goodness and to share the abundant mercy of Jesus, our Redeemer and friend. Amen. Please be seated. As our time of worship comes to a close, just a couple of announcements regarding the life and ministry of the congregation. And Jessica's already making her way up, so I'm going to let her go first.
I got a list.
Yeah, go for it.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
So I had to make a list for this for our announcements. I'll start off with the most important, Sunday morning treats. We all enjoy those. So we thought to make it more consistent, I put a sign-up sheet next to the flower sign-up sheet. So if you're willing to bring something or donate money so someone can go buy something or make something, let's do that so we can be more consistent so we know every Sunday we'll have some treats, because it's really cool to see everybody sitting around talking and kids knocking people over to go get their treats and some grown adults following them. So so that's the first thing that's new for this week. Second thing is, in 2 weeks, we have our No Rummage Rummage Sale. So we're going to be grilling. Tim will be grilling. Let's clarify. So grilling, we're going to have brats, hamburgers, hot dogs, and pulled pork available. Breakfast, we're going to have breakfast items with coffee and stuff. And there's a sign-up sheet for donation for items. There's a whole list, from condiments to chips to whatever. So also spaces for money to help pay for the meat, which we're going to take care of purchasing so we know we can control that a little bit. We need items, but also we need bodies. So it's Friday and Saturday, the 26th, 27th. Sorry. So we're hoping we're busy. You know, when people rummage in the area, hopefully they're hungry. So if you can spare some time, we greatly appreciate it. Bring your lawn chairs. Hopefully it's beautiful weather like this weekend. So there's that. There's also a button on the card reader that says Ashwaubenon. So if you want to donate for this event, click that and we'll make sure that the youth get that money. And it's donation only for the community. So we're that's going to support the youth. So that's why we're doing this. The final thing is, I don't know if you're going to say it, but the Booyah sale is today for
Booyah!
The Scouts at the Ace Hardware on Ridge Road. So it started half an hour ago, and it'll go until they're gone. So if you want to support the Scouts, that's that. That's it.
To warn you on that, if you stay for a cup of coffee, you might be out of luck with the Booyah. So, choose wisely, okay? Yes. Flo, you got something for us? Come on up.
Okay, I have the information now finalized for the walking tour for those who are interested, who have read The Maid and the Socialite, which is a novel written by a local author about the Minahan family. She offers several tours during the summer months, and it is a two-hour walking tour around the Monroe Street, Clay Street, downtown area. It's $18. And the date has been finalized as June 2nd, and it's at 2 p.m. I had said noon last week, but it is 2 p.m. Her tours usually fill up very, very fast. So I have a special deal at $18, otherwise it's $21 to take this tour. So if you want to sign up, I will be at the back. I've already received, I think, 12 people that have signed up.
Wow.
She will take reservations up until the date of the tour, but I guess since she sells out very, very fast, it would be good to get in as soon as possible. In fact, I will be sending her the list that I already have tomorrow, so it will be opened up to the public at that time. So I will be back there if you have any questions.
Thank you, Flo. Rob, you got something for us?
Yeah.
Cool, come on up.
Just a reminder and also a thank you. Coming up this Saturday, starting at about 9 o'clock, we are gonna be making the pizzas that everybody ordered. So if you signed up to help, or if you're around and would still like to help, we will be meeting at church about 8:45 on Saturday, and hopefully be done about noon. This year, we sold 690 pizzas. So that is the most, since I've been doing this, that's the most we've ever had. So thank you for all of you guys that ordered. And if you missed out this year, we did order a couple extras, not a whole lot, but we'll definitely be doing it again, I'm sure, in fall. So thank you guys.
Wonderful. Thanks, Rob. One last thing that I want to mention, there's information in the bulletin about the book study of Bonhoeffer's Letters and Papers from Prison that Lutheran Office for Public Policy in Wisconsin is going to be holding. If you're interested in that, let me know. I'll get you the Zoom link. The book is available on Amazon, there's a couple of different editions of it. Check with me and I'll help you make sure that you get the one that's the really nice print. Augsburg got this one right. It's great, all right? If you're interested but you're not able to make the Zoom Bible book study, or you just don't care for Zoom book studies, you'd rather be in person, I would love for us to do one of these here. So let me know about that, and we can probably get something set up for that as well. Thank you to everybody who came to our movie night this last week. It was a great turnout. And really a remarkable story, and keep your eye out. We'll be doing more of those kind of events as we go into the future. All right, that's all I've got for announcements. Anybody got anything big going on in their lives in the next few days, like a birthday, anniversary, anything like that? I see we got a couple people coming forward. It's both of them. Hey, anniversary, Mazel Tov. All right, and Sue Ann, birthday. Wonderful. Let's say a word of prayer. Good and gracious God, we thank you that you have changed our lives. By the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, you are shaping us into new creations given for the sake of the world. And we thank you today for the members of this congregation that are celebrating today and in the days ahead. We thank you for those who celebrate birthdays, for Sue Ann, for Alexis, for Rachel, and for Barb. As they celebrate birthdays, Lord, continue to pour out your good gifts on them, that they would be a blessing to everyone that they meet, revealing your grace in their very lives. We pray too for Jessica and Trent as they celebrate an anniversary. Continue to strengthen and support them in their promises of love and faithfulness to one another. Fill their hearts and their home with love, and grant that they would see in one another the life-giving love that you have given us in Jesus. It's in his precious and beautiful name we pray. Amen. Sue Ann, happy birthday. You buying dinner? Yes, very good. You buying dinner? Yes, all right, wonderful. Happy anniversary, y'all. Anybody want to help me with a blessing? Come on up. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Yep. Let's go. We got all the time we need. It's good. Okay, here we go. Blessings go on ahead, so we do this, right? Put our hands out like this. And you say the words with me. The Lord bless you and keep you.
The Lord bless you and keep you.
The Lord's face shine upon you.
The Lord's face shine upon you.
The Lord look upon you with favor.
The Lord look upon you in favor.
And give you peace.
And give you peace.
And we make a big cross. Amen.
Amen.
All right, thanks. Let's stand up. We're going to sing our sending song. This is a newer one. This is from the new hymnal that we have. And we're going to sing through it two times. Joy with all, working for a world that's new, faithful when we hear Christ call. May the God of hope be with us every day, to a world in need with news of joy and peace. May the God of justice speed us on our way, bringing light and hope to every land and race. Praying, let us work for peace. Singing, share our joy with all. Working for a world that's new, faithful when we hear Christ call. Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God, and we will.